IVM.
Hey guys, welcome to the Positively Unlimited podcast. I'm Chetna, a healer and coach who believes in empowering people to live better lives. Over the last few years, working with clients and helping them through different blocks and hurdles, I've realized that once empowered, with the right habits and mindsets, we can truly create a life we desire and deserve. These right habits and mindsets are what I call positive action. In this series, I'm taking you through the A to Z of positive action. In each episode, I talk of a mindset, a way of thinking, of being, that can help you discover your potential and create a life you want to live. Be the person you want to be. I'm creating a gorgeous deck of cards and a DIY workbook for all those who would like to take positive action. Stay tuned for updates on how and where to get your copies. But for now, here's episode 1. And the first card that I pull from this deck is A for Align. Align your thoughts, words, and actions for optimum results. What do you want? What are you chasing? A lot of times when I ask people this, the first response is, I don't know. Maybe I don't want to feel this way. Or then I get a, I don't want that to happen. I don't want to be this way. Well, the question was, what do you want? If you are thinking about what you don't want, if you don't have clarity to express what you want, how will you know what you need to do to get what you want? Confused? I am too. And this is why being aligned is important. When you are aligned, you have clarity of thought. Your words express your truth. And you're able to take appropriate action. Let me give you an example. I feel like having coffee, so I walk into Starbucks. But at the counter, when the staff is waiting for my order, I say, I don't know what I want. I don't want to have tea. Maybe green tea? No, but I don't feel like that either. And this goes on for a bit. At this point, the guy behind the counter is trying very hard not to roll his eyes at me. And maybe other customers behind me are shifting weight from one leg to the other. There's a palpable irritation coming through. The result? I get something I don't want. Doused with annoyance and irritation. Mine and those of all those people standing behind me. Let me give you a different scenario. Let's flip it. I feel like having coffee. I walk into Starbucks. I look at the list of coffees and pick one. Maybe I ask the staff for an explanation of something new on their menu or a recommendation. The staff replies, I make a choice, I pay, and I get my coffee. I knew what I wanted, I got what I wanted. There's no reason for me to stand there and say I don't want tea when all I need to say is I want coffee. And yet, we stand in front of that counter in confusion so many times, not knowing what we really feel like. We're like this in life too. We don't take the time to understand what we want or what we want to feel and experience. We're so focused on our fears and controlling outcomes of situations. We're putting all our energy into the don't want. Our focus is almost always on the worst case scenarios and all that can go wrong. So what do we get? Either nothing or that which we don't want. Let's try this today. Stop using the phrase, I don't know. Replace it. You could use, give me a bit to decide, or let me think about it, or I'll let you know. For most of us, I don't know has become a reflex. And it's a response that keeps us in a state of confusion. So let's start speaking with a little clarity by eliminating words that are the exact opposite. Step 2, let's make a conscious effort to express what you want and not what you don't want. If you are wondering how to do that, just flip the sentence. If the first thought in your head is I don't want, take a deep breath and ask yourself, what do I want? Or what's the opposite of that? Step 3 would be to express what you are thinking and feeling. Not what you should be thinking and feeling, and definitely not those thoughts of fear and doubt. Just speak as you think. Yes, add the needed filters to avoid being rude or mean. But those filters don't need to change your original thought. Those filters are about how you speak or say something. They aren't about controlling what you say. In these 3 simple steps, you are unlearning some thinking and speaking habits. you're changing the way you communicate with yourself and others. Give this a shot. Make a note of what blocks you, the situation in which the person with whom you feel the struggle, or even the thoughts or words that you struggle with. Identifying that hurdle is step one to overcoming it. Let me give you another example, one that's not as simplistic as ordering tea or coffee. So say there's this person who is unhappy in their job. When asked, "What do you want?" their response is, "I don't know. I just want to get out of here. But I don't know how. And, you know, I need the money. I mean, I have bills to pay. I can't be without a job." So what should this person do? Well, frankly, I don't know. Maybe get a new job or start a business or just suck it up and keep working because there are bills to pay. This kind of conversation always leads to a bunch of options and no action. Why? Because nobody knows what will help. Which problem are we solving? Are we resolving the unhappiness, or are we finding a way to make money, or are we figuring how to get out of this job? Now imagine we asked this person, "What do you want?" And they said, "I need to get a new job, one that pays me well and is interesting and challenging." Awesome. Just listening to clarity puts one at ease. In this response, the person's thoughts, feelings, and words are aligned. They have expressed what they want and why they want it. Clearly, they feel stagnated in the current job and/or they aren't interested in the role anymore. So now, the person can think of steps to take. Identify the kind of job they'd like to do, as in which industry, role, company, etc. Next would be to spruce up the resume, and step three would be to apply. Sounds simple? It is simple. But our fears can complicate matters. In spite of knowing what they want, this person may continue to suffer in the current job because they're afraid to apply for a new job. Maybe they believe they won't get something they like. Maybe they believe they won't get paid as much as they would like to. Working through our fears and doubts is a big step in staying aligned to our true selves. It's okay to be afraid. It's okay to be full of doubt. But it's not okay to stay that way. So here's something you can try. Think about what you want. It could be a thing, feeling, or an experience. Write it in straightforward, affirmative, crisp sentences. Don't use words like don't, not, or can't. And don't write a long story. Just 2 to 3 short sentences describing what you want. Now, every time you talk about this desire or the situation around it, express what you want instead of any fears or worry. Literally mug up those 2 to 3 sentences and repeat them. It's okay. Remember, this requires conscious effort. So be aware of how you are speaking. And now that you know clearly what you want, think of 3 things you can do to move closer to fulfilling that desire. 3 steps or actions, working towards creating all that you want. Within a week or 10 days of doing this exercise, make sure that you do at least 1 of those 3 steps that you put down. You had a thought, you expressed it through words, and now you need to act in alignment. Thinking, speaking, and acting in alignment is a powerful habit to cultivate. It allows us to be true to ourselves. It helps build our belief in ourselves, conviction in our ideas. Being aligned in our thoughts, words, and actions also helps improve our relationships. It creates that feeling of honesty, trust, and reliability. It changes the way we communicate and the way we make choices. So that was A for align. Tune in for episode 2, B for be still. In this day of running marathons, learning to be still is just as important. Remember, the Positively Unlimited podcast season 1 is about the A to Z of positive action. It's time to change your life, one alphabet at a time. To stay in touch with me, connect with @positivityangel on Instagram or Twitter and Circle of Positivity on Facebook. I also have a website called circleofpositivity.com, and the next episode will be out next Monday on IVM Podcast website, app, and all other podcast platforms. So until Monday, stay aligned to your being.
There she stands, a podcast addict. outside the bank, having traveled several miles to get in with other poor souls like her. The journey, though daunting for this youngling, will have some comfort because she has downloaded her favorite podcast. You can see more of her species on ivmpodcasts.com, your one-stop destination where you can check out the coolest Indian podcasts. Happy listening.